and we can be appointed, but our heart is not right.
Yeah.
Somebody need to help me preach over here.
Yeah.
And so he said, you was beautiful when I created you. What happened to you, oh Lucifer? Let's find out. Let's find out. Verse 14, thou art what? Anointed. You can be anointed, but your heart ain't right. Because gifts come without repentance. He said, you was anointed. You can do everything. When they sing your voice, nobody can sing like you. Michael Jackson ain't got nothing on you. Nobody can sing like old Lucifer. Nobody can play like old Lucifer. He was great. But there's a conflict that was about to take place. And so that's why, Minister Deborah, we got to examine that heart. Because that's where a conflict began. It begins with the heart. He said, thou art what? Anointed. Keep reading, church. Thou upon the holy mountain of God. Come on, church. Until iniquity was found in thee, with your anointed self, until iniquity was found in thee, I had to do something with old Lucifer, because this is a conflict in glory. Jesus said, I beheld Satan as lightning as he was tossed out of heaven, because there was a conflict. If God had to dismiss conflict, why we can't dismiss it? Talk back to me, church. Created you. You was beautiful, but when there was conflict, I got to get rid of conflict. Tell your neighbor, say, get rid of conflict. Come on, come on. Y'all need to prophesy to somebody, because somebody still want to hold on to conflict. Say, get rid of conflict. He says, verse 15, thou was perfect in what? Thy ways, the day thou was created to iniquity, what? Keep reading, church.
The multitude of thy merchandise, they have filled the midst of thee with violence, and thou hast seen. Therefore, I will have been profaned out of the mountain of God. I have destroyed thee, O cover your cherub, from the midst of the stone of the fire.
Thy heart was what?
Lifted up.
Because what?
Thy beauty.
Don't let your gift get you in trouble, church. Your beauty gets you in trouble. You start smelling yourself. You start looking at yourself too long in the mirror. Instead of looking at God, you looking at self. He said, Lucifer, you got to be beside yourself. You know, we get beside ourselves. We working out every day and we forget about God. We losing weight and we forget about God. And you got to be careful. Iniquity will come in your heart right away. Say to neighbor, be careful, be careful. He said, thou was perfect in thy ways from the day thou was created to iniquity was found in thee. And let's go to verse 17. Thy heart was lifted up because of what? Thy beauty. Thou hast corrupted what?
Thy wisdom, by reason of thy righteousness, I will cast thee to the ground. I will lay thee before kings, and thou shalt behold thee.
Amen. Stop right there. Conflict started in glory. And God had to do something with conflict. He had to dismiss conflict. He said, I'm not the author of confusion, but I'm the author of peace. Give God a hand praise. Listen. The Bible speaks about in 2 Corinthians 4:17, for our light and temporal affliction is producing for us an eternal glory that for outweighs our trouble. It outweighs your trouble. What you are going through, God is saying, I'm building you, I'm making you, I'm perfecting you. Even through the conflict, don't mean you're going to stay in conflict, because I prepare a way for you to escape. And so God is saying, allow me to make and mold you. Say, allow God to do it. Deal with conflict. Conflict will then make you attack others to cover yourself. So you attacking others because you got a conflict on the inside. Instead of covering, you attack. mode.
Yeah.
How come you never attack people all the time? And so you attacking people in the church because you got conflict. Amen. Say, deal with it.
Deal with it.
Amen. Give God a hand praise. Now. We got to deal with this because God is saying, I want you to be able to go through the process. Say, go through the process.
Go through the process.
And to go through the process, you got to understand that in Luke chapter 22, verse 31 through 32, read it at your leisure. He says, Jesus was telling Peter that same desire to sift you as wheat, but I pray for you that your faith fail you not, so you can go and strengthen or convert your brother. And so he says, Satan desired to sift you. How do he want to sift you? Because he wants you to have anxiety attacks. He wants you to be frustrated where you can't sleep at night. That's conflict. He desired to sift you as wheat. You came to get your health together because you're worrying all the time. So he desired to sift you as wheat. And your health is failing you. And your finances is failing you because you're focused in on the problem and not the promise. Say, get focused on the promise and not the problem. He said he desired to sift you as wheat, but I pray for you that your faith fail you not. And so God is saying that we got to deal with the conflict that we go through. It's only what we're going through. Say, we're just going through something. Don't mean you want to stay there. You're going to come out. Say, I'm coming out. I'm coming out with power. Say, power. Tap your neighbor, say power.
Power.
Say power right now.
Power.
Give God a hand, praise for power.
Hallelujah.
He said, I have given you power to tread upon serpents and upon scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by enemies hurt you or harm you. He said, I have given you hind feet to walk upon thy own high places. You got power. The enemy bring conflict in, so you feel like you don't have no power. But when you are a born again believer, you got a dominus power to bounce back, to let the enemy know that made all these things, I am more than a conqueror. Now, where we have to understand there's a process that we have to go through. But I understand the process, but learn something in the process. Say, learn something in the process. Let's deal with something. When someone offends you, that could create conflict. And people don't come back to church because we got offended. And it created a conflict. Now let me I'm gonna walk through this, dealing with this, because the thing about it is that people are trying to mess you up. Jesus had to deal with the Pharisees and the Sadducees. And so we still got Pharisees and Sadducees, but they just dress up. They have a wig on. They got the big hat on. They got a suit on. They got a title on. But they still got that Pharisee and Sadducee spirit to throw you off course. Don't allow people to throw you off course. As Apostle Alfred taught me years ago, the best deliverance is to be delivered from who?
People.
Let's deal with this. Let's go to Luke chapter 17. Let me support this in scripture. Thank you, sir. Luke chapter 17. Let's go to verse 1 through 6. Now, his disciples was asking him how to deal with people. How to deal with religion, or how to deal with people that is inside at this time the synagogue, or how to deal, as we bring it to the 21st century, Benita, how to deal with church folks inside of the church. He says, then said, what he unto his what?
Disciples.
It is what?
Impossible.
But that what?
This is will come.
He said, stop right there, church. He said, they will come.
They will
come. I don't care how much Greek and Hebrew you know, they will come. Conflict will come. will come. Offenses will come. And so we can't rebuke or offenses when they come, but we have to deal with it, and we have to deal with it with the right attitude. Because people can say the wrong thing to you and mess you up. Yes, they can. He said, disciples, I can't do nothing about offenses when they come, but I can give you an application that will help you to deal with offenses. Now, let me deal with when someone offend you. Right now, it's talking about become a stumbling block. People will come and be a stumbling block so you don't get to your destination. Yes. We read earlier that we got to run this race. Yes. And so they want to trip you up as you are running. That's a stumbling block. People want to have snares or traps to get you in where you can't finish your race, where you can't finish your course. We got destiny killers out here that's trying to kill your destiny, trying to kill your vision, trying to kill the baby that you are trying to give birth to. And our vision kills, and you have to watch out who you share your vision with. He said, disciples, I can't do nothing when people offend you, but I can tell you what you can do. Let's read. Let's take it from the top again. Then said he unto his what?
Disciples.
It is impossible, but what?
That offenses will come, but woe unto him from whom they come.
Stop right there. He said, woe. He said, holy disciples, if they touch you, if they talk about you, there is a woe to them. There's a warning. That's why you never put your mouth on a man or woman of God. He said, touch not my anointed, neither do my what? Prophets nor harm. You pray for them, but there's a woe when you mess with God's children. That's why he said, suffer not the little children, but I want them to come to me. God is saying, there's a woe to them that do you wrong or try to set up traps and snares for you, try to create conflict in your life. There's a woe to them. Vengeance is mine, said the Lord, and I will repay them who do you wrong. God is saying your enemies will become your footstool that will catapult you to the next dimension. He said, woe unto them. Look, keep reading. If it were well. Now we dealt with offend. I want to slow it up. Offend means at this particular time become a stumbling block, a snare, a trap, anything that hinders someone from doing what is right. That's what offend here means right here. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let's continue to read.
Take heed to yourselves. If thy brother trespasses against thee, rebuke him. And if he repent, forgive him. And if he trespasses against thee seven times in a day, turning again to thee, saying, I repent, thou shalt forgive him.
Stop right there. Say, neighbor, be quick to forgive.
Neighbor, be quick to forgive.
When you forgive, it's for you. When you keep things on the inside, you create conflict. And so there's a conflict because unforgiveness is inside of your heart. That's iniquity that is inside your heart. And people haven't forgiven one another, and so they're growing bigger or bitter on the inside of them, and it creates a conflict. You got to learn how to forgive quick. Say, learn how to forgive quick. Now Jesus having given the boys the answer how to deal with people offend them, but we're about to run into it. Let's keep reading, church.
And the apostle said unto the Lord.
Let's start at verse 4. And if he what?
And if he trespasses against thee 7 times in a day, and 7 times in a day, turn again to thee, saying, I repent, thou shalt forgive him.
And the apostle said unto the Lord, what?
A priest shall pray.
That's it right there. To deal with church folks, to deal with people on your job, to deal with life itself, you got to say, increase our faith.
Yes.
That's how you deal with it. Because the Bible said we go from faith to faith and glory to glory. God is saying that it's time for God want to increase your faith. And so when your faith is elevated, when someone offend you, you're on another dimension now. Because it made me stronger. It made me better. matter because I'm quick to forgive and I'm going from faith to faith. And so the disciples said to Jesus, increase our faith. That's how you deal with circumstances and life situations. Because if your faith is still the same faith that you had 2 years ago, you're in trouble. If you've been in church for a little while, your faith, you should be soaring like an eagle now. You shouldn't be walking on the ground like a chicken, but your faith should be elevated higher. Say, elevate the faith, God. Give God a hand, praise. Come on, we can do better than that. We dealt with First Lady in Psalms 42 and 5. Why art thou cast down, O my soul? Let's visit that again in Psalms 46, Psalms 42 and 5. When you get to the point where you don't want to elevate your hand in praise and worship, something's going on the inside. When you don't want to participate in worship or praise and worship, something going on the inside. Because there is a season, as I explained some weeks ago, that we go through the season of the Gethsemane point, where the battles of the will, where I don't feel like coming to church. I don't want to read my Bible. I don't want to pray. But then you got to say, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will to be done in me. Amen. Let's go to Psalms 42 and 5. It says, why are what? Oh, my soul, why are what? It said, hope thou in God. And so don't allow, through conflict, don't allow the enemy to destroy your hope. Because hope is connected to faith. Without hope, you cannot have faith. Amen? He said, why art thou cast down, O my soul? Why art thou what? Disquieted in me. And so keep in mind that you was at one time praising and worshiping God. You was coming to church on the regular. You was doing all those things, but there's a point of conflict that have came into your life, has shut down your praise.
Yes.
Has shut down your worship. But the psalmist said, I will bless the Lord at what? All times. And his praise is what? Shall continually be in my mouth. And my soul shall make her boast in the Lord, and the humble shall hear thereof and be glad.